record this session. All right, let's get started with our warm up. Nice little jog. Keep it going. I'm just gonna recenter this. I'm not sure why it's a nice light jog. I think I made it worse. Go ahead and do some jumping jacks. Always an option to take out that hop and just step side to side. Welcome if you're just joining us. No worries, we're just getting started with the warm-up. Just set a medium and or heavy weight for today. Alternating hand toe taps, bringing that leg up nice and high. Let's do one more on each leg. And then a nice hip opener over to a side lunge. And chest stays nice and lifted. And then coming down to a nice low wide squat, heels and toes, that arm reach out by your side. Reach down, tapping the opposite inside ankle. Chin and chest stays up so you don't get lightheaded. And then staying center, arms forward in a windmill motion. And then reverse the direction, opening up your chest. And then slight hinge forward, staying low in that squat. Give yourself a nice, tight, big hug, squeezing your shoulders together as you open up the arms. A few more here with your breath. On your next exhale, gently coming down to a rounded lunge, left leg forward, pressing forward, opening up that right hip, left knee is not passing your toes. Straighten that left leg, knee point, flex your left toes. One more time, press it forward, opening up your right hip, and straighten that left leg, point, flex the left toes. And then quickly switching, left leg back, right leg forward, pressing and opening up the left hip on the side, not letting your right knee pass your toes. And then swing your right leg, may point, flex your right toes. And then pressing it forward, opening up that left hip one more time in your warm up. And then straighten the right leg, point, flex the right toes. And then come on up. You can grab your one set heavy weight. We have a squat to alternate back leg extension. Timer has begun. So just alternating the leg that extends back. We're trying to keep that leg nice and straight, really squeezing the base of the feet. We have three moves in every set. We're gonna do everything three times, cycling through. Nice low squat, alternating straight leg back extensions. 40 seconds each move. Last seven. Then you have a 10 second breather. And two. Last one. Set the weight aside to the front of your area. We're going to come into a burpee. As we come up in our half burpee, we're going to extend the weight out first for a chest extension and then back down. So stepping or tapping the feet back, chest extension, and then setting the weight down. If you're stepping the feet back, please make sure you're alternating the feet that go backwards and forwards first. Keep it going. Stepping or hopping. Keep it moving. 10 seconds to go. Last five, three, two, and one. Set the weight aside. Come to a tabletop position. Wrists are under your shoulders. Knees are under your hips. Tuck your toes, lifting your knees a few inches off of the mat. From here, we have bear crawl jack. So just jacking the feet out, always option to just hold up air, having your knees covering the mat, bear crawl jacks or holding the bear. Nice work all across the screen. Keep it going. Either holding that bear or adding the jacks. Last 7, 5, 3, 2, and 1. Coming back to the top. Option to grab that weight. Squat, alternating leg extensions behind you. Nice straight leg. As you come up from that squat, take the leg behind you. Flexing that foot as you extend the leg back. Chin and chest stays nice and lifted. Imagine you're sitting in that imaginary chair behind you. Squeezing the base of your seat to get that leg a little bit higher every time. Last 10, just like this. Weighted heart center between your palms if you're using a weight. And then setting the weight in front of you. We have our half burpee, stepping or hopping. Weight comes to center chest. Extend out for a single chest press and then repeat. Keep it going. Nice low squat. Grab the weight. Extend it out from your chest. Bring it back in. And then hopping or stepping your feet back to a high plank position. Keep it going. Moving with your breath. This is round 2 of 3. Last 7. Finish wherever you're at. Set the weight aside. Come back to our tabletop position. Knees under your hips, wrists under your shoulders, touch your toes, lift your knees a few inches, and add in those jacks. Always an option to just hold the bear. You can also alternate stepping the knees out. Core stays nice and engaged. Driving your belly button up towards your spine. Keep it going. Bear crawl jacks, bear crawl holds, or alternating side step out. Keep it going. Nice flat back. 7 seconds to go. Last 3, 2. All right, bring it on up. If you'd like, grab that weight. Low squat. Alternating leg kickback. Nice straight legs. Flexing the feet as you extend that leg back behind you. Ever so slightly hinging forward as you come to a standing position. Working the base of your seat. Keep it going. Last time doing this. Very nice. Looking so good all across the screen. Last 7. Almost there. Last 1. Set the weight at the front, top of your area. Half burpee to a single weight chest press. Join me when you're ready. This is the only time we're doing burpees today. Keep it going. Half burpee, hopping or stepping. Maybe challenging yourself for this full round by hopping. As you come to that low squat position, grab the weight. Extend it away from your chest. Gently pull it back in. Final 10. See how many you can do in this last few seconds. Last 3, 2, and 1. Set the weight aside. Come to your tabletop position. Wrists under your shoulders, knees under your hips, touch your toes, lift your knees, and jack it out. 40 seconds is on the clock. Nice low back. option to hop the feet. You can also step side to side, alternating the legs, but step out each time. Nice flat back. Looking so strong all across the screen. Final 10, push through. We have a nice breather after this. 3, last 2, and 1. Release everything down, grab some water. You gotta breathe it after this. You got 20 seconds still. We will use the weight for our next belt. You can use 1 or 2. We have a lateral lunge to a knee drive with an oblique twist to a curtsy. Coming back to starting. Lateral lunge, knee drive, tapping opposite knee, opposite elbow to a curtsy. Keep it going. Feel free to add in the steps in between your lateral lunge, your knee drive, and your curtsy. Keep it going. Lateral lunge, knee drive, oblique twist to a curtsy. Keep it moving. Looking so good all across the screen. Last 3, 2, and 1. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Left lateral lunge or right to the left side last time. No worries. Join me when you're ready. Lateral lunge, knee drive, oblique twist to a curtsy. Lateral lunge, knee drive, oblique twist, curtsy. So you're just gently tapping your right elbow to your left knee as you bring it up from that lateral lunge. Keep it going. Very nice. Total body here. Working the inner and outer thighs. Always working that core. Upper body, lower body. Last one. From here, go ahead and roll all the way back. This is a new one. Grab your heaviest weight, place one behind your head. We have reverse crunch. So lifting your hips up, bringing your hips up towards the ceiling, and then we're dragging our opposite knee towards our opposite elbow. Using that weight behind your head to hold you in place, lift your hips up towards the ceiling, opposite knee to opposite elbow. Keep it going. Always an option to just do lower body hip lifts. Hips lift up towards the ceiling. Working those lower abs here. Keep it going. Coming in and up. Grabbing your weight. I recommend a little bit lighter for this one. Lateral lunge, knee drive, oblique twist to curtsy. Whatever you remember of that, right or left, we'll do the other side next. Keep it going. A little bit of balancing act here. Really engage your core to control your movement. Last 10 on this side. Going strong. First 3, last 2, and 1. Set it up for the other side. Ooh, already sweating today. Lateral lunge, knee drive, oblique twist to curtsy. Join me when you're ready. The timer has begun. Very nice. Slow it down as much as you need to. Not going for speed on these. Almost there. Last 7. And one. Set your weights down. Option to do a lower hip lift, or if you want to add on, keep those hips lifted up towards the ceiling. You can have a soft bend in your legs as you keep your hips up, drawing opposite knee to opposite elbow. Slow and controlled movement, always an option to just raise and lower the hips. The slower you go, the more challenging it's going to be. Gently releasing your hips down towards the floor. Not using any momentum of swinging your body. Oh, that was a fast 40 seconds. Coming back on up, back to the top. Last round, lateral lunge, knee drive, oblique kick to curtsy. Join me when you're ready. Very nice. Adding in those floor taps wherever you need them. Keep it going. Last 10. Going strong for 5. Last 3, 2. Finish up wherever you're at. Shake it out. Let's set it up for the other side. Left leg lateral lunge. Knee drive to an oblique twist to a curtsy. Chin and chest stays nice and lifted. I'm walking down your street again. Keep it going. Past your door. Almost there. Don't live there anymore. It's years since you've been moving with your breath. Now you've disappeared somewhere. Keep it going. 10 seconds to go. Last 3, 2, and 1. Come on down, laying onto your back. Legs up towards the ceiling. Lower leg lift, or you can add in that twist. Opposite knee, opposite elbow. It's a bit of a challenge. You can try it out. Opposite knee, opposite elbow. Always an option to gently and slowly lower and raise your hips, using that weight behind your head to stabilize your upper body, not using momentum to lift and lower your hips. Slow and controlled for 1. All right. Go ahead and grab some water. You won't need any equipment for our next 3 moves. But keeping your body still, have 17 seconds. First up, we have our cardio blast. We have ankle taps forward and backward. Opposite ankle, opposite hand. Join me when you're ready. Forward, forward, backwards, backwards. You can slow it down or add that hop. Just tapping opposite inside ankle. Very nice. Feels like we're all doing like a little status dance. It's so cute all across the screen. Keep it going. 12 seconds to go. You got this. Opposite ankle, opposite hand, with or without the hop. For 3. Last chance. And 1. Coming on down to the mat. Coming to a high plank. We have 3 high plank jacks to a pike up to 3 jacks in our pike up. So we're going to alternate the legs wide and the legs narrow. Keep it going. 3 jacks. And our high plank, three jacks, and our pike up. Keep it going. Alternate legs wide and legs narrow as you pike up in between. Last three. All right, come on down. Sitting onto your back. Grab your set of weights. We have a C-sit hold. So knees are bent, legs off the mat. Round your back as far as you can without losing your balance. And alternating bicep curls. You can also straighten the legs for a bit more core challenge. Maybe round your back further towards the mat, bringing your waistband towards the mat. Core stays nice and engaged. Belly band pulled into your spine. C-sit curl or straight legs. Alternating bicep curls for five. Last three, two. Set your weights aside. Back to a pop. Alternate opposite ankle tap. Two forward, two back. Opposite hand, opposite ankle. Keep it going. Always an option to take out that hop. Or you could always add the hop in. Last 15, keep it going. Really bringing that ankle up so you're barely tapping it with your hands. For three, last two, and one. Come back to your mat. High plank, three jacks, pike up, three pike jacks. Bring it back down the high plank. Join me when you're ready. Alternating. Your feet being narrow and wide between your high plank and your piked up jack. Keep it going. Last time, you got this. Last two. And one. Come on over to your back side for our C-sit or V-sit alternating bicep curls. Round your back. You can always keep your heels on the floor. That's the first move. You can lift the heels for our C-sit alternating bicep curls. If you want more of a core challenge, you can straighten the legs and round your back towards the mat. Make sure your core is engaged, belly button pulled into your spine, looking so strong. Last 10, push through. Almost there. For three, last two, and one. Set the weights aside. Coming back up, alternating opposite inside ankle tap. Last time doing this. Adding a hop or taking it out. See a faster song. Keep it going. I see you. Opposite ankle tap. Very nice. Maybe trying to get that ankle up even higher. It's a nice hip opener. And we're bringing the leg to the front. Last 10. Keep it going. For three, two, and one. Whew. All right. Kneeling down at your mat for a high plank. Feet are narrow or wide. Three jacks. Pike it up. Three pike jacks. Take it back down. Keep it going. Last time doing this. The number three, so we alternate wide and narrow legs as we come to and from the pike up. Keep it going. Last seven. 3, 2, and 1. Flip it on over when you're ready. Grab your set of weights. Coming into our bicep curls. Feet on the mat, option one. Lean your back, bringing your waistband towards the mat. Option two, lifting your feet, coming into a C sit. Still bicep curls. Option three, extend your legs straight. Focus on your breathing. You can slow those bicep curls down as much as you'd like. Very nice, looking so strong. Last 10, just like this. Center so strong. So close, almost there. Last 3, 2, and 1. Set the weights aside. Ooh. Grab some water. Still got 20 seconds, don't worry. First up, we have our cardio blast. Coming to a squat, we have little scissor switch. So right foot front, left foot back. Option, take out that hop and just squat, alternating stepping side to side. So you're alternating which foot comes in front. Little inner and outer thigh work. Just a gentle squat. If you want, just alternating which leg comes in front as you come to a little hop. Keep it going. Increasing that heart rate. Very nice. Lovely hops all across the screen. Last 5, 3, 2, and 1. Grab your heavier set of weights. We're gonna come into a lunge. We have our weight portion. Right leg back, left leg forward. Come to your nice lunge stance. Get nice and cozy. We have alternating split squats with single leg deadlift. Chest stays nice and lifted in our split squat. Keeping that right hip over your right knee as you come into that lunge. Left knee does not pass your toes. Sliding the weight down the front of your left shin. Last 5, 3, 2. Take it out. You know what we're gonna do next. Switching sides, left foot back, right foot forward. Follow your left foot press into the mat, alternating. Split squat with single leg deadlift. Your left hip stays directly over your left knee as you come into that split squat. Chin and chest stays nice and lifted as you come into that hinge for our single leg deadlift in front of the right leg. Just glide the weight down the front of your right leg. Very gently. Last 10. This isn't for speed, so slow it down as much as you need to. And set the weight aside. Back to the top. Scissor jumps are alternating. Low squat. Which leg comes in front? If you're adding that hop, just bringing one foot in front of the other, alternating with each hop. Keep it going. Just a gentle squat as you land. Have a soft bend in your knees. Land on the ball of your feet, not your heels. Moving with your breath. Last 7. Going strong for 3. Last 2 and 1. Grab those heavier weights. Left foot forward, right foot back. Get nice and cozy, alternating. Flip squat to single leg deadlift. Slow it down. These aren't for speed. Next is a neutral spine as you hinge forward in your single leg deadlift, gliding the weight down the front of your left shin. Keeping a nice soft bend in both of your knees, not locking out either knee. Keep it going. Very nice. Slow and controlled for five. Last three, two. Finish up wherever you're at. Shake it out, switch sides. Step backward with your left, right foot forward. Nice bend in your knees, alternating. Flip squat to a single leg deadlift. Keeping that hinge in your back as you come into the deadlift. Upper body stays upright with your split squat. Ball of your left foot pressed into the mat. Soft bend in both of the knees the whole time. Keep it going. Almost there. Slow it down. Focus on your breathing. Last two. And one. Set the weights aside. Last round. Scissor jump. Let's do this. We got this. 40 seconds on the timer. Slow it down. If you need to, take out that hop if you'd like. And when you're ready, pick up that speed. Halfway there. Keep it going. Almost there. Very nice. Last 10. We got this. Last 3, 2, and 1. Whew. Grab those heavier set of weights. Take a big step back with your right. Nice one stance. All terrain. Flip squat, single leg deadlift. Slow it down. We just brought our heart rate up. You're still burning maximum calories with your heart rate still increased. No need to go for speed here. Lunging it out and then coming into our single leg deadlift. Last 10 on this side. Almost there. Power through to the end. All right, shake it out. We're almost there, we're so close, I promise. Big step back with your left, alternating. Flip squat to a single leg deadlift. Keep it going. I don't have any surprise burnouts for you today. I'm so sorry, but we're not done after this. Keep it going. Nice breather after this. Power through all the way to the beep. Last 10, alternating split squat, single leg deadlift. Soft bend in both of your knees at all times. All right, set the weights aside. We will use them again, don't worry. Grab some water. You still have 20 seconds. All right, grabbing your weights. Come to your mat. Coming to a high plank position. Weights under your wrist. We have alternating dumbbell rows and a high plank. So rowing the weight up, elbow up toward the ceiling, timer has begun. Think about drawing your elbow up toward the ceiling and the weight shouldn't come by your chest. It should come down towards your rib cage. Always an option to come to a tabletop position. Elbow up towards the ceiling. Weight towards your rib cage as you bring the elbow up. Last 10. Core stays nice and engaged, whether you're in a high plank or tabletop. Set it aside, scoop it on over, go with those weights. We're gonna come into a wide leg, glute bridge hold. Toes are flexed, toes up towards the ceiling, weight overhead, one or two. Pulling the glute bridge, we have a skull crusher. One or two weights. Feet are wider than your hips. Heels in, toes out. Toes lifted up toward the ceiling so your feet are flexed. Squeeze your glutes the whole time. Lifting your hips up toward the ceiling as you simultaneously add a skull crusher. So just your arms are moving. Just your elbow bends and extends. Last two. Grab your second weight if you only use one. Good old-fashioned chest press. If you want to add more heat, add that leg raise and lower. Join me when you're ready. Wide arm chest press. Legs straight together. Leg raise and lower. Keep it going. Your chest press can be as fast or as slow as you'd like, but if you're adding that leg raise and lower, make it slow. As slower than you think you should. The slower the better. Engage that core. Last 10, just like this. Keep it going. Core stays engaged. Lower back press into the mat. Chest press. And then flip it on over. Coming back to the top. High plank or tabletop. And alternating rows. Elbow up towards the ceiling. Weight comes up towards your rib cage, avoiding your chest, working the back. If you're in that high plank, you're doing double duty, full body moves here. When that plank, core stays nice and engaged. Keep it going. High plank or tabletop, alternating dumbbell rows, last 10. Core engaged. For last two, one, and then coming on down, flipping it on over. One or two weights, skull crusher, wide leg, heels in, toes out. Squeeze your feet, lifting your hips up towards the ceiling, hold it here, and add that skull crusher. Toes up towards the ceiling. Keep it going. Really squeezing your feet. Static glute bridge hold. As you simultaneously add a skull crusher, one or two weights. Please don't drop the weight anywhere near you. Last five. Keep it going. Or engage. Grab that second weight if you only use one for your skull crusher. And we have our neutral press. So palms facing in towards one another, legs straight. You can do your neutral press up. If you'd like, you can add a leg raised and lower. You can also keep the legs just out straight. Lower back pressed into the mat. Neutral press, always an option to do tricep push-ups. Keep it going. Last 10, just like this. Keep it going. We have one more round. Last two and one. Set the weights aside. Flip it on over. High plank or tabletop, alternating dumbbell row. Elbow comes up towards the ceiling, avoiding your chest, bringing your weight up towards your ribcage. Keep it going. Really squeezing your shoulder blade as you bring that weight up. Very nice. I love the planks all across the screen. Keep it going. Core stays nice and engaged. stabilizing yourself, keeping your hips parallel. Last 10, just like this. Last 3, 2. Finish up wherever you're at. And when you're ready, flip it on over. Bring the legs together. Legs zip together. Toes flex, lift your glutes up. Full pressure. Keep it going. Toes up towards the ceiling. Heels pressed into the floor. Full pressure, 1 or 2 weights. Keep it going. Hips stay up towards the ceiling. Just a bend and extend in the arms. Almost there. Keep it going. All right, chest press of choice. You can do a wide arm chest press or a neutral press. With or without that leg raise and lower. Legs are slower than your chest press. Wide arms or neutral. Keep it going. This is it, last bit of work. Push yourself, remember why you came to class today? Almost there. Halfway there, 20 seconds to go. Lower back stays pressed into the mat. With or without those leg raises, push through. Last 10, almost there. Moving with your breath. For 3, last 2, and 1. Set all of your equipment aside. Roll on over to the front side. Hands under your shoulders. Pressing your upper body up for a nice stretch all across your abdominals, all across your chest. Looking over your left shoulder for a nice oblique twist. Coming back to center, looking over your right shoulder. And then pushing yourself back to a wide knee child pose. Knees wide in your hips, toes together. Fingertips stretched out in front of you. And think about coming as close to the mat as you can. Maybe think about pulling your armpits into the mat. You can tempt your fingers by lifting your palms off the mat, pressing your finger pads into your mat. It's a different stretch across your shoulders. And then gently walking your fingertips over to the right side. Place your left palm on top of the right. Press your left thumb towards your left heel and then gently rotating your left shoulder down towards the mat, feeling that nice deep stretch all across your left side. On your next exhale, gently walking your fingertips over to the left side. Place your right palm on top of the left. Press your right bum towards your right heel and gently rotate your right shoulder down towards the mat for a super deep stretch all across the right side body. On your next exhale, gently bring your finger pads back to center for one more stretch. And then coming up to a tabletop, wrists under your shoulders, knees under your hips, doing a few cat-cows with your breath, hand mixing your belly, gaze forward, rounding your back, bringing your gaze towards your navel, and just moving with your breath here. And then finding your neutral spine, nice flat back. Tuck your toes, bring your hands a palm point forward, lift your hips up, coming into a pike up down dog. Pressing your heels into the mat, toes are lifted for a nice deep stretch all on the back side of your legs. And then lifting your heels super high, pressing into your toes, and pressing your feet in down to the right side for a nice side deep stretch. Lifting your toes again and bringing your heels over to the left side for another deep side stretch along the other side. Lifting your toes one more time and then lowering your heels in the center. Gently walking your hands towards your feet and just having a generous hang on your neck, hang nice and loose. Maybe shaking it yes, maybe no. You can grab opposite elbows and sway side to side. Your legs can be straight or you can have a soft bend in your knees. Gently release your hands back down towards the mat and rolling up nice and slowly, one vertebrae at a time. Drawing your shoulder blades back and forward. Let's take deep breaths. And one more for good luck on this Friday. Thank you all so very much. If you haven't done so already, please make sure to put your name and your site in the chat so that can be tracked. I appreciate all of you. Make sure you stay hydrated, stretch, and drink plenty of water. Have a great weekend. It's supposed to be so hot today. Yay! Bye, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lauren. Thank you, Joy. Thanks, you,
Amanda.
Jay. Thank you, Suzanne. Thank you. Hi, Sian.